Last episode's comment of the game comes to you from Two Clutch Gaming, and he says, tough loss. Hopefully the O's can come back with a vengeance and tie this series up. So last episode, the Orioles did end up falling to the Braves in Game 1 of the World Series by a final score of 2-0, but they looked forward to Game Number 2 to try to tie up the series tonight. So if you guys want to be featured in the comment of the game, make sure at the end of this episode you comment down below to possibly be featured next episode. In Game 1, we saw a masterful performance from Matt Cain, going 8 scoreless innings, but it was erased by a 9th inning 2-run home run from Chris Johnson to give the Braves a 1-0 lead here in the series. So we look to Game 2, with the Orioles trying to tie up the series tonight. They send the Cy Young Award winner Wei-Yin Chen to the mound tonight. Game 2, coming up next. We are back here in Baltimore, Maryland, where we're just about set to start Game 2 of the World Series. The Braves lead the series 1-0 so far, and it's going to be a crucial game for the Orioles today. They want to win this game in front of their home crowd. So let's take a look at the pitching matchup for tonight's ballgame. On the mound for the Orioles is going to be Wei-Yin Chen, and on the mound for the Braves, Julio Teheran, where he's been dominant all postseason long. So here's the starting lineup for the Atlanta Braves. We're going to have to watch out for Jason Hayward, Hunter Pence, and Chris Johnson. If they can get something going, it's going to be a long night. So, of course, it's Wei-Yin Chen on the mound for the Orioles, where he's kind of struggled here in the postseason. So we're just about ready for first pitch. Game 2 is coming up next. Stepping to the plate for the Atlanta Braves is their designated hitter, Vernon Bass. So we are ready to begin Game 2 of the World Series. Wei-Yin Chen is ready. Let's do it. Here comes the first pitch. That's going to be driven out to deep center field. Going back is Adam Jones. He's in front of the warning track, and he will settle underneath that one and make the catch. So a scare here early in this game, but we do get our first out of the ballgame. Next batter up is going to be Omar Infante. 1-1 is the count. Here comes the pitch as he's going to drive that one into center field. That's going to be a base hit. So the Braves' first hit of the ballgame, and they are finally set up. So they started off the game a little slow last time. It was a pitcher's duel last game in Game 1. Let's see if that'll be different here in the next game. Next batter up will be Jason Hayward, and he's going to take ball 4. And the Braves, they're set up early. Runners on first and second base. Next batter up, Justin Upton. He's going to drive that one into center field. That's going to be a base hit. The runner's rounding third. He's on his way home. Here comes the throw. Here comes the play. It's going to be not in time as the Braves score their first run of the ballgame. And they're going to jump out to a 1-0 lead early here. Next batter up, Hunter Pence. Runners on first and second base. Here comes the pitch as he's going to drive that one into right center field. That's going to be a base hit as well. Splits the outfielders and goes all the way to the wall. Run's going to score. Here comes the second runner, and he will score as well, as that's going to be cut off. It's a 2-RBI double for Hunter Pence, and the Braves jump out to a 3-0 lead early in the ballgame. Next batter up is going to be strike 3 swinging, and we finally get out of the first inning, but still 3 runs given up from Wei-Yin Chen, who has been struggling in the postseason, and that's not looking too promising either. So next batter is going to be Chris Davis. He'll drive that one into center field. That's going to be caught by Jason Hayward. So again, the Orioles struggling to score some runs. They have not scored a run yet here in the World Series as we move ahead to the top of the second inning, I should say. Still 3-0 is the score. So here comes Wei-Yin Chen back on the mound, and that's going to be driven into left field. That's going to be another base hit given up by Wei-Yin Chen. He's still struggling here in this game, and it's just not been a postseason to remember here for Wei-Yin Chen. He has over a 6 ERA so far. Next batter up, Omar Infante. 1-2 is the count. That's going to be outside. And wait a second, Wei-Yin Chen does not look too good out there. It looks like he's going to have to be taken out of the game with some kind of an arm or chest injury. And maybe that's why he's been struggling. He did win the Cy Young. He's been pitching pretty well. And then this postseason, he's just been really struggling. We're going to have to take Wei-Yin Chen out of the game now. And that's a really big disappointment. So we're going to have to call on Kevin Gausman to try and get out of this jam that we are in. So he's been pitching pretty well. 2-0 with a 2.53 ERA. Can he get the job done for the Orioles and keep us in this game? Next batter up is going to be Infante. That's going to be a ground ball, a soft ground ball to Jamal Weeks. Throws it to second base for one. Back to first base. That's a double play. Just what we needed from Kevin Gausman, as his first pitch in the ballgame is going to be a double play. So we'll move ahead to the bottom of the third inning. Manny Machado up to the plate. Here comes the pitch. He's going to drive that one into center field. That's going to be a base hit. The first base hit of the ballgame for the Orioles, I should say. And Manny Machado continues to hit the ball very well here in the postseason. And can we get a run out of this? We really desperately need to score a run, as we have not scored one yet here in the World Series. Next batter up is going to be Matt Wieters. Here comes the pitch to him. He's going to drive that one into left center field. That's going to be a base hit. and the center fielder will make the catch, will field that one as Manny Machado will get to third base on the play. But the Orioles are set up. Runners on first and third base now. Can we get a couple runs here in this inning? We'll have to find out. The next batter up is going to be Nolan Rymel. Full count. Nobody out here in the inning. Here comes the pitch. It's going to be a soft ground ball right in front of the pitcher's mound. Teheran will throw that on to first base for the out, but it will be an RBI as that's going to be Manny Machado scoring on the play. The Orioles are on the board. The score is 3-1. So I'm still a little curious of why they ended up throwing to first base instead of trying to get the runner going home on the play, but it doesn't really matter. We do get a run out of it, but the next batter up will be Chris Davis. He will strike out looking there. And man, if he swung the bat, maybe he could have got a couple more runs in there. But anyway, we're still down by 2 runs. 3-1 is the score. Gossman's still on the mound. That ball's gonna be driven deep into left field. Going back is Bautista. He's on the warning track. He's at the wall, and he will make that catch right before that gets out of the ballpark. So that would have been a huge home run for the Braves as they would have went up 5-1. But thankfully, that stays in the ballpark to keep the game 3-1. Next batter up, 2-2 is the count, 2 outs. Runner on second base here in the top of the 4th inning. Here comes the pitch. That's going to be called strike 3, and we're going to get out of this inning as well. So Kevin Gossman, ever since he came in to replace the injured Wei-Yin Chen, he's been pitching pretty well, so we're going to move ahead. Bottom of the 4th inning, here comes the next batter. That's going to be Nick Markakis. He'll drive that one down the left field line. That's going to be a base hit and roll all the way to the wall. Nick Markakis, he's on his way to second base. He's going to get in there sliding feet first, as that's going to be a lead-off double for Nick Markakis. Can the Orioles get a couple more runs here to get back into this game? Next batter up, Manny Machado. Here comes a pitch. He's going to drive that one deep into center field, but that's going to be Jason Hayward settling right underneath that one. It was pretty much hit right to him. He's going to make that catch, though. Still no runs for the Orioles. 3-1 is the score still. We're going to move ahead. Bottom of the 5th inning. Matt Wieters up to the plate. Here comes the pitch to him, as that's going to be low ball 4, as Matt Wieters is going to walk on the play. So we are set up. Can we start getting a couple more runs? Can we try to take advantage of that leadoff walk? Next batter up, Nolan Rymel. 1-1 is the count. Here comes the pitch. He's going to drill that one deep into left field. Going back as a left fielder, he's not going to get there. A 2-run home run for Nolan Rymel, and this game is tied. A absolute huge home run for Nolan Rymel, as we're going to get back into this game now, as we have really not have much offense in this series so far. A huge home run right there. Next batter up, Adam Jones. Full count. Here comes the pitch to him. That's going to be swung on and missed. Strike 3. As that's going to be the 2nd out of the inning here in the bottom of the 5th. Next batter up is going to be Chris Davis. 2-1 is the count with 2 outs. Here comes the pitch. He'll drive that one into left field. Going back is the left fielder, Upton. He's on the track. He's not going to get there either. Another home run for the Baltimore Orioles as we're going to jump out to take the lead now. 4-3. A huge home run. We finally have an offensive outburst here as the Orioles are going to take the lead here in the 5th inning. We're going to move ahead to the 7th. The Orioles finally got some offense. They lead this one 4-3 now as Hunter Pence goes down swinging. And we're only 6 outs away now from tying up this series. We lead 4-3. We're going to move ahead in this game now. And it's going to be the top of the 8th inning. We're going to call in our setup man, Andrew Bailey. And Kevin Gossman really saved us here. He did not give up a run. He pitched 8 innings, I believe. Or 7 innings, I should say, or something like that. I'm not really sure, but he still pitched very well. So hopefully our bullpen can now keep us in this game. Andrew Bailey on the mound, our setup man. He's had a very nice season so far as the first batter is going to walk. Here comes the pitch as that's going to be driven into left center field. Going back is Jose Bautista as he will settle underneath that one and he'll make the catch. So the Orioles, after all, are only 3 outs away now from tying up this series 1-1. So we're going to move ahead. Bottom of the 8th inning. Can we get a couple insurance runs here in this game? We're going to find out. Bottom of the 8th inning. Chris Davis up to the plate. He's going to hit that one deep into left field. Can he have another home run? Pretty much the same part of the ballpark, but this time Justin Upton will make that catch, crashing into the wall, just missing another home run Chris Davis did. And we'll have to take a look at that replay. That seemed like there was a nice catch as Justin Upton right in front of that wall. He leaped and made that catch right before it got out of there. So unfortunately, we did not get any insurance runs, but we're going to call in the closer, Tommy Hunter, who had a shaky season, but he did pick it up later on in the season. Can he get the job done? 3 outs away from tying up this series. Here comes the first batter. 1-1 is the count. That's going to be grounded into right field. That's going to be a base hit. So the first batter up is going to get a base hit. So there is a runner on first base for the Braves, I should say, as can we try to get the double play ball that we've been getting a lot so far in the game. Next batter up, Jason Hayward. Here comes the pitch. He's going to drive that one into right center field. Going back is Nick Markakis, and he won't make that catch. That's going to be down for a base hit. One run's going to come around, and he will score on the play, and this is a tie game. So what just happened? It looked like Nick Markakis was going to make that catch, but all of a sudden the game is tied. Now Jason Hayward gets the third base on the triple, and take a look at this replay. How maybe he lost it in the lights or something, but a huge mistake a couple batters later. That's going to be driven deep into left field. Jose Bautista will make that catch, but the runner is going to tag, and he will score on the play. So unfortunately, we did throw home trying to throw him out, but it was not a great idea because runners do advance. So runners on second and third base now. But out of that, now the Braves lead this one 5-4. Ground ball, Chris Davis will field that one, step on first base. And we're going to have to come back now. We're going to go to the bottom of the ninth inning, needing to score at least one run to keep this series alive. And 5-4, the Braves lead this one now on a huge mistake there from Nick Markakis. So here comes JJ Hardy. He'll drive that one into center field. That's going to be a base hit as the tying run is on base. So a home run can win it. But again, a huge mistake right here from Nick Markakis. Maybe he'll make up for it, but we don't know. I mean, that is a really big mistake. So the next batter up, Manny Machado, the team MVP. Here comes a pitch, and that's going to be called strike three on the slider. And that just absolutely fooled him. He must not have been looking for that pitch. But the next batter up, Matt Wieters, is going to pop that one up. Omar Infante settles underneath that one, and he will make the catch. The ball game is over. The Braves come back and win this game in the ninth inning. So they did it in game one. They scored two runs in the ninth. They do it again here in game two by scoring two runs in the ninth again. Final score in this one, 5-4. The Braves lead this one. And man, that just killed us right there. Nick Markakis' huge mistake not being able to make that catch. And we're going back to Atlanta now, trailing the series 2-0. And it's not looking too good for us. We're going to send Chris Tillman to the mound for game three. But this has happened before when the Yankees in 1996, they were trailing 2-0 as they went to Atlanta. They won all three games, brought it back to New York, and won game six as well. So maybe that'll happen here in the Orioles franchise, but a huge mistake. Hopefully you guys did enjoy this video. I do apologize, man. That was a huge mistake from Nick Markakis not making that catch. But the Orioles are gonna have to come back here in game three, hopefully win this game, because if they go down 3-0, you don't see many teams down 3-0 come back. So a huge game, game three. Come on back tomorrow night. Hope you guys did enjoy this video. If you want to be featured in the comment of the game, make sure you comment down below to possibly be featured next episode. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Have a good day, guys. Peace.